Thank you. Until the First World War, Iraq was known in the Western world as Mesopotamia, the cradle of civilization. Arabs used the name Iraq as early as the Middle Ages, but it was only formally adopted in 1921. Iraq is a complex mosaic of culture and geography. The vast farmlands of South Baghdad lie between the two great rivers of antiquity, the Tigris and the Euphrates. Baghdad was founded in the year 762 by the Arab Caliph al-Mansur. It soon became the seat of the vast Arab Empire. Some of the world's oldest archaeological sites are found south of the city, near the ancient ruins of Babylon. The Tigris River bisects the ruins of the ancient fortified city of Ctesiphon, founded by Alexander the Great. One of the world's earliest Christian churches still stands along the banks of the Tigris River. Western Nineveh province is near the area described in the Bible as the Garden of Eden. It remains one of the primary crossroads of civilization. The ancient city of Hatra, built in the 6th century BC, served as a key trading post for the Persians, Greeks, Romans, Arabs, and the Ottoman Turks. Alexander the Great's army marched through this region in 331 BC to fight the Persian army on the plains of northern Mesopotamia, where he won his greatest victory at the Battle of Gaugamela. In the 2nd century AD, the Romans came to the region and established a garrison and fortified the ancient city of Sinjar. It served as one of the critical outposts of the Roman Empire in the region. The Mongol horde swept in from the north in 1258 and sacked the great Arab cities of Mosul and Baghdad. Over 500 years ago, the Ottoman Turks built a castle on top of the ruins of the ancient Assyrian fortification in the city of Tal Afar to secure an area populated by Turkmen, Arabs, Kurds, and Yazidis. The British wrested Mesopotamia from Ottoman-Turk control at the end of the First World War. In 1920, unrest in Tal Afar sparked an uprising against British rule across Iraq. The British Army built Fort Tal Afar to the east of the city to re-establish control of the area. After short-lived monarchies and a series of military coups, the Iraqi people suffered under 3 decades of the rule of Saddam Hussein, who ran one of the most brutal and murderous regimes in history. This is the land where the brave Rifles fought alongside their Iraqi comrades to accomplish a mission vital to the future of the long-suffering Iraqi people and the security of our nation. Saddam Hussein used the fertile farmlands and luxurious riverside mansions of South Baghdad as rewards for top party officials, military officers, secret police, and intelligence agents. After the fall of the regime, the area became one of the most volatile regions in Iraq and a staging area for terrorist operations against Baghdad. Upon arriving in South Baghdad in early April, the regiment immediately conducted reconnaissance and offensive operations to defeat the enemy insurgent network and deny the enemy the ability to disrupt political and economic development in the capital city of 6 million people. In the middle of May of 2005, the regiment received a new mission to defeat a highly organized terrorist network in western Nineveh province. Thunder Squadron initially reinforced with Predator Battery, a platoon of engineers, and Iraqi army advisors from Tiger, remained in South Baghdad to give the 3rd Infantry Division the combat power it needed to defeat a deeply rooted terrorist network and protect Baghdad from the devastating attacks originating from this area. Late summer of 2004, Iraqi security forces in Tal Afar collapsed and the town became an insurgent training area and staging base. 2 months later, terrorists used this area to organize and conduct a systematic attack on Mosul, a city of 2.5 million people. Foreign extremists combined with local insurgents and began a reign of terror that choked the life out of the city and victimized people throughout the region. Saber Squadron, a small element from the regimental headquarters and a logistical element from the Mule Skinner Squadron, led the regiment to Tal Afar in late April. The brave rifles immediately challenged the terrorist stronghold and the enemy suffered heavy losses.
late May, while Thunder Squadron assumed a brigade-sized mission south of Baghdad, the regimental headquarters, Tiger Squadron, Longnet Squadron, and Mule Skinner Squadron joined Sabre Squadron and began combat operations across western Nineveh province. The regiment immediately launched Operation Veterans Forward to conduct reconnaissance and establish security across the vast Syrian border region, a region the enemy was using to access external support from Syria. Squadron, 14th Cavalry, and Longnet Squadron conducted its own reconnaissance in the vast Jazeera Desert region of Nineveh and El Anbar provinces to the north bank of the Euphrates River. They uncovered weapons caches and killed and captured 8 foreign fighters responsible for the kidnapping and death of the governor of El Anbar province. Tiger Squadron, reinforced with Sapper Company and Predator Battery, established itself in the west and alongside Iraqi army, police, and border police, re-established control and defeated the enemy. Tiger's bases spanned over 100 kilometers from the border town of Rabia to Sinjar to Biyaj, a town that Tiger liberated from the terrorists at the beginning of June, and immediately re-established permanent security with Apache troops, Iraqi army, and police. Longnet Squadron, organized with the newly formed Quick Strike Troop, conducted reconnaissance and security operations in the vast desert and along the Syrian border. The regiment could not have conducted this operation without the work of Mule Skinner Squadron. The squadron moved thousands of tons of building materials, fuel, water, and ammunition across an area covering 22,000 square kilometers and sustained these fast-paced and wide-ranging operations. As the regiment fought in northwest Iraq, Thunder Squadron was the keystone of the 3rd Infantry Division's counterinsurgency efforts in South Baghdad, while they also secured the most critical supply route in theater. Their aggressive pursuit of this enemy dealt a severe blow to the terror network in this critical area, killing scores of enemy and detaining hundreds, breaking up enemy terror cells. Thunder Squadron's tireless efforts in this area allowed the Iraqi army to establish a permanent security capability in an area vital for the protection of Baghdad.
Al-Afar, Saber Squadron disrupted the enemy's safe haven, developed key intelligence sources, setting the conditions for a large-scale combined offensive to free the city from the grip of Al-Qaeda in Iraq, known locally as the Battalions of the One True God. The enemy could not afford to lose this safe haven where they incited sectarian violence and trade terrorists for employment throughout Iraq. In July, Al-Qaeda in Iraq proclaimed that the Lions of Tal-Afar would defend Tal-Afar at all cost and repel the infidel invaders. The regiment and the 3rd Iraqi Army Division began planning Operation Restoring Rights, an effort that would bring together the largest combined offensive operation in 2005. From the 24th of August until the 23rd of September, the troopers from Tiger Squadron, Saber Squadron, Mule Skinner Squadron, Long Knife Squadron, and the newly arrived 2nd Battalion, 325th Airborne Infantry Regiment conducted one of the most effective urban offensives in recent history, defeated the terrorists in Tal-Afar, and established permanent security for the people. Before the brunt of the fighting began in the terrorist stronghold in the Sarai district, the regiment evacuated innocent civilians and provided them with humanitarian assistance. The regiment killed over 200 terrorists and captured over 800 trying to flee the stronghold that Al-Qaeda had sworn they would never abandon.
Unity of effort between the U.S. forces, Iraqi army, Iraqi police, and Iraqi civilian leadership was extraordinary. The brave rifles fought alongside Iraqi army soldiers and police. They forged bonds based on mutual respect and common purpose. The Iraqi army and Iraqi police also gained the confidence needed to take the lead in providing security for the people of the region. Soldiers who fought with the brave rifles exhibited courage, discipline, compassion, and endurance. They brought life back to the city of Tel Afar and across western Nineveh province. In January 2005, most people in western Nineveh province could not vote, and the people of Talifar lived in abject fear of terrorists who kidnapped and murdered anyone who advocated peace and cooperation. The people of South Baghdad were also brutalized and too intimidated to vote. Terrorists wanted the political process to fail. Less than 1 year later, voters turned out in droves to South Baghdad's polling sites. In western Nineveh province, voter turnout was over 87% and over 90% in Talifar. The people of Iraq were able to choose their destiny. The regiment's security efforts allowed people to vote, and they were determined to take their future. The troopers of the Brave Rifles left Iraq having earned the respect and gratitude of the people. The troopers of the 3rd U.S. Cavalry helped secure the future for the children of Iraq and the children of our own nation. Over time, and under the tough conditions of combat in Iraq, the 3rd U.S. Cavalry Regiment became a family. The Brave Rifles are proud to have served together on their vital mission. Proud to have served alongside fellow soldiers willing to sacrifice everything, including their lives, for one another.
Look at this photograph! Every time I do, it makes me laugh. How did our eyes get so red? And what the hell is on Joey's head? This is where I grew up. I think the president would have fixed it up. I never knew we ever went without. The second floor is on for sneaking out. And this is where I went to school. Most of the time I'd better things to do. Criminal record says I've broken twice. I must have done it half a dozen times. I wonder if it's too late. Should I go back and try to graduate? Life's better now than it was back then. If I was them, I wouldn't let me.
If I want to make a couple extra bucks by selling a part or two off on my Chevy.
Goodbye, goodbye. Every memory couple of kids since then. I haven't seen her since God knows when.
Accomplishments of the mounted riflemen and those who rode with them in Iraq have inspired gratitude among the Iraqi people and their fellow Americans. The troopers of the 3rd Armored Cavalry Regiment dismantled the terrorist networks along the Syrian border, shattered the backbone of Tal Afar's brutal insurgency, and crippled the violent terror cells plaguing the capital from the farmlands of South Baghdad. They brought smiles to children's faces, ink-stained fingers to citizens that had never voted, and security to schoolyards that hadn't heard laughter in years. These courageous cavalry troopers rode into South Baghdad and western Nineveh to defeat the forces of hatred and violence. They left behind places where they rekindled hope and freed good people from fear and oppression. The troopers wrote the latest chapter of the proud history of the Regiment of Mounted Riflemen. They preserved the legacy of courage and excellence inherited from those who went before them. General Winfield Scott's words, spoken to the regiment's troopers at Chapultepec, resonate as loudly today with the troopers who fought with great distinction in Iraq. Brave rifles, veterans, you've been baptized in fire and blood and have come out steel.
May it be an evening star shines down upon you. May it be when darkness falls, your heart will be.
The regiment's troopers honored the sacrifices of their fellow troopers with their deeds as they continued the mission. They keep the families of their fallen comrades in their thoughts and prayers. They resolve to live well and cherish both the memories of their fallen brothers and the freedom that these men fought to preserve.
May it be when darkness falls.